My name is Lucas, and I'm an engineer on Google Web Designer. In this video, we'll talk about how to use Google Web Designer's 2D and 3D drawing capabilities. To start, I will draw a div, which is an HTML container element. So I select the tag tool, and we see that in the upper bar, I have some options that control the visual appearance of the div. So I can set the color like this, and I can choose how rounded the corners are. If I click and drag on the stage, then I see the coordinates of the upper left and lower right corners of the element, and also the element's width and height. And when I let go of the mouse, the element is created. Once you have some geometry on the stage, Google Web Designer attempts to make some inferences about this geometry to help you align things more cleanly. For example, right now, it's detected that the mouse is near the upper edge of that element that I just drew. So if I draw a new element, its top edge is aligned with it. I can then align the bottom edge of the new element with the middle of the original or with the bottom. If I switch to the selection tool, I can move the element around. By clicking on one edge, I can snap to other edges in the scene, and by clicking on a corner, I can snap to other corners. This snapping behavior can make it easier to align your elements. But if you don't want the behavior, you can turn it off by going to the View menu and unchecking the Snap option. Google Web Designer also provides a set of basic 2D drawing tools. For example, I can draw 2D Bezier curves, I can create rectangles, or ovals, or lines. If I select an element, then I can edit its properties in the Property Inspector. For example, I will change the color of this element, and I will change its width and height. Right now I'm dragging in the text field to continuously change it, but you can also just type in a value. To give another example, I will select this oval, I will change its fill color, and I will give it an inner radius to convert it into a ring. While all this that we've done so far is in 2D, Google Web Designer is built on a 3D architecture. And to see this, I will turn on the 3D grid. I can now rotate the view of the stage with the View tool. And we can see that all the elements I just created are in the XY plane. And if I rotate far enough, then a different plane, in this case the YZ plane, becomes active. So with that active, if I draw a new element, then it is placed in that plane. If I once again rotate the view, you can see I have one element in the YZ plane and then everything else in the XY plane. If you want to return to the default view where you're looking at the XY plane, just double click on the View tool. So far, we've only created elements in 2D and viewed them in 3D, but we can also edit elements in 3D. So here I've selected the Rotate tool and an element, and now if I drag on the element, I can freely rotate it. I can also rotate it about a specific axis by clicking and dragging on these rings. When you use the Rotate tool, there are two modes, a local mode and a global mode. When you're in local mode, you rotate about the element's local X, Y, and Z axes. So right now, I'm rotating about the element's X axis, and here I'm rotating about its Z axis. If you're in global mode, then you rotate about the stage's axes. So here I rotate about the global z-axis. You can also translate elements in 3D. So here I translate in x and in y. This is still in global mode, so it's in the stage's coordinate system. But I can change to local mode and now move along the element's own x-axis or y-axis or z-axis. If I drag the element itself, then I translate in the element's plane. Finally, if I select part of an object and hold the Control key, I can snap that part to other elements in 3D. So right now I've snapped these two corners together, and you see that if I rotate the view, they are exactly stuck together. So that concludes this look at Google Web Designer's 2D and 3D drawing capabilities. Thank you for watching.